Hello everybody and welcome back to the Mega Modded series. We are back again and I entered this room just before I started recording. Got locked in there again, so don't know which mod does that, but that needs fixing again apparently. Anyways, we're jumping into a run. I have to say, I'm gonna be wholeheartedly honest here. I am real tired. I don't know why. Oh, fucking pea shooter. What the hell bullets are these? Like little top hat bullets? Plague? Oh, it's like a plague duck. That's cool. Has a chance to shoot a bouncing plague bullet on fire. This curse. Their cure is most efficient. This is pretty cool. I like the idea. If it synergizes, like, well with pea shooter, as in, like, I get, like, a decent amount of them from my pea shooter, it could be pretty cool. Pea shooter is actually not too bad as, like, a first floor weapon. But yeah, I was just about to say, I'm gonna be honest, I'm, like, real heckin' tired. I don't know really why, but, like, last night I didn't manage to get to sleep until, like, 4 a.m. And I know for some people that's fucking child's play, never named, looking at you, you sleepless fiend. I know that he's got insomnia and never sleeps a wink, but still, for me it's not normal. And I am just knackered. I'm not used to this, and I'm just, I don't know. I'm having a bit of a low energy day. And I had an energy drink this morning to try and counteract that. I say I had one this morning as if I wouldn't have had one any other day of the week, whether I was tired or not. But I did have one this morning as per usual. Didn't seem to help much at all. I don't know. I'm having a low energy day. And do you know what? It's probably gonna lead to a little bit of a low energy Gungeon episode. But I think sometimes those can spawn some interesting episodes, just because I usually find that when I'm doing low energy, I wouldn't even say just low energy, but when I'm sort of doing low effort, and I don't want to say my content is low effort, but low effort in that, you know what I mean? As in, like, I can just play a game and chat shit. I think they spawn some of the best conversations because I could just, like, ramble on about a random subject or, like, talk about my day. Which, unfortunately, I have to say, I work from home now and... Ooh, Radgun. I do gotta say, I love working from home. It's the best thing ever, especially considering my place of employment is very good about, like, working hours. It's very much just get the job done. There isn't really any hard restriction on hours worked or anything like that. So it's very generous in that regard. Also, is this a not a bot shrine? Hello. So in that regard, it's really nice. But in the other regard, my God, do I have so little stories to talk about when, so little stories to talk about because I don't go anywhere. I don't see any people. I don't do anything. I mean, I heckin' love it. Like, don't get me wrong. I'm a very social, antisocial person. I feel like I kind of like to be and need to be fairly social. Haven't seen a single plague bullet, by the way, so far. I feel like I'm a fairly social person. Just gonna grab that. I'm a fairly social person, even though I like not being around people. Sort of in the way that, like, I like talking to people, like, via text through Discord, like, through my YouTube Discord, and then just talking to people on Discord chat a lot of the time as well. I play games with my friend Luke. Not Rogue Luke, actually. I have two close friends called Luke. It's a strange time. But anyways, one of them I play Warzone with, like, all the time. Nice. And, yeah, I gotta say... So it's nice to speak to people like that sort of thing, but I do also very much sort of like my time alone when I'm working. So if I like to just not have to work with other people. Sounds really antisocial, but you know, we'll take the honey pot, see what it does. I'm gonna guess it just puts some honey on the floor. Throwable pot of sticky honey. Yeah. Decent enough. I thought it was gonna be something such. Basically this is just gonna slow down enemies from walking. I don't know if it slows down fire rate. I doubt it does. I don't see why it would, to be honest. Will it slow down this guy? I wonder. Well, we would know if I didn't completely whiff that shot. Okay, let's try and get some... at least a few of these going on. Okay, let's at least see if this works. I'm curious. Nope, this thing flies. I kind of expected it to fly, but also sure. Oh, did we just get the hive holster? If this doesn't have a synergy, never name, I am going to actually shit a brick. Okay, thank God it does. Honey, I'm home. I like the name already. Right, so I believe if we take a little look, hive holster here. Small hive of bees seems to have taken up residency in this old holster. I love that. Basically, I believe that when we reload, we throw out a few bees. Let's go see what this old synergy has got hiding away for us. Let's have a little look-see, shall we? Once more into the breach. Oh, I just opened my browser and then closed it. I told you I'm tired today. Once more into the breach, Gungeon. Here it is. And we want to go to synergies. And I'm going to search honey and hope for the best. That's the bane of arthropods. Honey, I'm home. Here we go. Aww. To be fair, this is a decent synergy, but I was hoping it'd be something to do with the hive holster rather than the honeypot. Increases the radius of the honeypot's honey by 3. So it's going to be a pretty big radius now, which, to be honest, is a fair synergy. I'm absolutely fine with that, I'll be honest. I was just really hoping it'd be like, spawns a lot more bees or spawns like hornets or something. Ooh, we got a new table tech as well here. Slide tech slide. What the heck? Whee! Crash. I kind of have to see. I'm really hoping this is just an absolutely nonsense bullshit item that makes you slide across tables at the speed of sound. Oh! Not what I expected at all. I have to admit, I hate it. In a way that I absolutely love. It's so terribly pointless, and I'm so grateful of that. I see no real use to use that during a room, but I love that it exists. Joke items like that are great, especially table techs have such a nice ability for those D tier, barely useful items. I kind of like them. Right, about as useful as Table Tech Rocket, let's put it that way. Right, I really hope we do get some plague shots at some point here. I've not seen any yet. I'm really hoping it's not a bugged item. It's very possible it could be. It's probably an item that hasn't been updated in a while. But yeah, as I was saying, it's just like, working from home, it's great, but at the same time, you don't really get the stories that you get when you go to work normally. Like, I mean, I've not got as many from my last job. I worked at a university for a little bit. So I've not got as many, and I only worked there for like a year. Actually, to be fair, I worked at my other job for like a year, so. But anyways, that wasn't as eventful, but the job I had before that, I worked at just like a regular shop, a store. I did like 9 months there as like a till assistant, just like ringing up people's orders, putting them through the till. And then I did the remaining time, which was like another 4 or 5 months as a like a sales associate. I can't remember what it was. Senior sales, that's what it was. You started off as an assistant sales, and then I went up to a senior sales, which essentially meant that I had the keys to open and close the shop, and I had to like count all the money at the end of the day sort of thing. Right, let's get some honey on this bitch. Yeah, that is a significantly larger pool. Wow. I significantly wrecked that boy. Significantly so. And we also got a cool headband. I do believe this is just coolness for the amount of money that we currently hold, which is decent. Whee! I love the visual effect of the water spreading. It doesn't just immediately create the pool. It kind of spreads slowly. I like that a lot. Breaker cash, locked armor, key bullet effigy. I don't think any of those are all that good. I do like the brick of cash though. I will buy that. And I'll buy that too. I never remember. Does brick of cash actually apply to the floor that you're currently on? Whee! Yeah, don't even bother. Nice. Yeah, I can't remember if it applies to the floor that you're currently on. There's a chance it doesn't. In which case, we're missing out. I threw that honey, and it was not a good idea. But we can get rid of some of it. We are. And replace it with ice. There's my hive holster going off. By the way, you might notice my hive holster isn't really doing much right now, but that's because we're using the rad gun, which means I'm never really reloading an empty clip. Why are these in here? Hello, boys. I'm never really reloading an empty clip, which of course causes some issues with the fact that hive holster only triggers on an empty clip. So basically, we're just kind of waiting to get some more appropriate weaponry before we end up actually like properly utilizing that, which is, it's a shame that we're not utilizing it, because I think hive holster is, hive holster and like the black holster as well are like two of my sort of favorite, they're my favorite like modded items, where they're not really, of course they are modded in the way that they're modded items, but they're very grounded within Gungeon reality. They play on things that already exist, and they don't really stray too far away. This is probably a good hive holster gun, by the way. We'll try this out. They play on things that already exist, sort of thing, and yeah, they're not too big of a departure, but I really do enjoy them. Oh my god. Should not have fallen in that pit. Let's get rid of some of this honey. That's kind of funny. It's kind of funny, honey. But yeah, this setup with hive holster is interesting. We're getting a good amount of bees, and honestly, this weapon, for a D tier, I'm not exactly sure what it is, but it seems pretty good. The double gun. The result of a one-night stand between a shotgun and a revolver. I like it. But yeah, works exceedingly well for our current needs. Also, the bees are pretty good damage, as you can see. Yeet. I'm actually quite liking this this honey pot's size. The synergy's pretty good. We got ourselves this thing, which is the glazer beam, which is a pretty interesting one. And we also got ourselves the Y beam, two different beam weapons, and it didn't need to find a secret room. Luckily, it's a completely useless secret room. So Y beam, as you can imagine, does a whole Y thing, and the glazer beam is that. I'm not sure what these bullets are. I'm gonna imagine that's something to do with the plague bullets not working. But yeah, two custom beam weapons. Pretty interesting. So with this thing, you want to sort of get at just the right range to hit both the beams, which currently we are. Probably shouldn't have done that. On bosses, it melts. It's also decently good with aim assist, too. Yeah, against bosses, and also, heck in hell, this thing's ammo efficient. We also got these bullets, which I cannot remember the name of. We are getting a lot of Once More Into the Breach items right now. So I believe all of those we deal extra damage to now? Or is it just that we insta-kill them now? I can't remember. Basically, that list of enemies we just saw then, we're now gonna pretty much insta-kill. It won't be quite an insta-kill. Is there a reason we blanked upon entering this room? Or did they just all die? I don't know. Armor bandage. Let's have a look. I'm guessing getting armor heals you. Taking damage to armor heals half a heart. Yes. Okay. Cool. I like the idea. Let's go. Okay, this is a pretty cool run we've got put together here so far. I am enjoying. I am thoroughly enjoying. Right. Yeah, this Y beam, I think it's gonna be pretty good. I think controller aim assist makes it pretty decent. It's just going to be, I love guns like this where, kind of like the mass shotgun, where you've got to use them in the right circumstances to get the full potential out of them. Otherwise, like, the single beam on its own doesn't really do too much for you. I will have to say, though, I am enjoying this thing a little more just because I get to use the hive holster more effectively. Also, this thing's just a very effective D-tier weapon, which is not a bad thing. I don't think it needs a nerf. I think it's actually pretty well-powered, pretty well-rounded. Yeah, if we can do that where we, like, slow down the enemies and don't actually end up slowing down ourselves at all, real nice. Look at all the bees. Look at them go. Need to watch out for our little gray dude. Okay. Probably just take it for this. Keeping my eye out for him now. I don't know if the bees have a range limit. Doesn't seem like they do. I'm really liking this weapon. Very satisfying. Again, it's another one of those weapons I was just sort of talking about, where it's very grounded in Gungeon reality. It's not, doesn't feel super modded, but it is good. Ooh, the RGG. The RGG is an interesting prospect, and it's a gun that I very much like. I very much like it indeed. There's a lot of nitros about. Oh, you really had to do it, didn't you? Push me directly into it. Okay, I didn't realize that. Enemies that we have the extra damage against actually have a little, like, notation above their heads to let us know. But yeah, as I was actually saying before I got sidetracked by myself, like, when I worked at the store, goddamn, I had stories for days. Like, something crazy happened pretty much every day. To be fair, the store that I worked at, it's now gone completely. Like, if you go to where it was, it is just, it's been flattened. Because it was in a really not so great area and it was very run down and, like, wouldn't say poorly managed, but it hadn't been updated or anything in a long time. So yeah, it was a kind of a shithole. But the one upside of that is it was a shithole, but it meant that only locals came to it, which meant that I basically knew every customer. Not all of them by name, but I knew a lot of them by name, and I knew most of them as in, like, I'd see on a daily basis, so I'd know their face sort of thing. Which was always nice. I think the sense of community in that aspect was really enjoyable. But it did also mean there was a few bad eggs that would come in every now and again. And now, none of them were really harmful in any way. Like, we had a few people that would try to steal on the regular. They wouldn't ever be, like, aggressive or... Ooh, hello, trash bag. Isn't this the mag size for trash? Yeah. Yeah, they'd never be, like, aggressive or anything, but there was quite a few people in there that would try to steal on the regular. And considering it was a shop, like, without really booze or cigarettes or anything like that, it wasn't really that much of value to steal. People mainly tried to steal the fresh meat, like, the steaks, which were, like, not even good steaks. Like, I wouldn't want to buy those steaks, I'll be honest. But yeah, so it led to quite a lot of funny stories. I've told this one before. I mean, it's a while since I have, and we have quite a few new viewers, because I think the last time I actually spoke about this story was prior to Repentance coming out, which means there's probably a good amount of viewers that haven't heard this before. I do remember one time, standing, like, I was manning the till, like, serving people, and there's a guy in the queue, and he was talking about, politics and, like, who was gonna, like, what party was gonna get voted in, and asking people who they voted for, which already is something you don't really do in the UK or anywhere, really. So it was already a bit of a strange thing to do anyways. Right. I haven't seen my boy, by the way, so we'll go look for him. Did I miss him? Wait. Have I not finished the map? What? Okay, well, let me sort this out first. But yeah, like, so I was, I was serving people, and he was just in the queue, and he was, like, asking people who they voted for and stuff, which is just, like, kind of a no-no anyways. And he just starts saying some views that I have to say are a bit questionable. And one line just really, like, hit me. Not as in, like, it hurt me personally, but I was a bit, like, I wasn't, like, super offended, but I was a bit like, holy fuck, how can you think that? He said, this is an exact quote, by the way. He said, I don't know, the rapists, the murderers, the lesbians, they should all be thrown in jail. Those are the people that he grouped together. What? How on earth does your brain even make that deranged link? I cannot fathom what a just misguided upbringing you have to have to think that. What did we get from this guy? What did you give me? Oh, you gave me this. Is that Table Tech Black Hole? Also, where's my dude? Where's my small boy? Also, Gilded Hydra, pretty good. Let me do a little run back through and see where my small friend is. Yeah, and I was just like, what? And this is a guy that used to come in regularly and was a fairly normal dude up until this point. Like, we'd not really heard him say anything super outlandish. And then he's like, yeah, I don't know. The rapists, the murderers, the lesbians, they should all be in jail. I was just like, excuse me? I feel like even most homophobics wouldn't think that being a lesbian is as bad as being a rapist. I mean, I know there's a lot of really, really, really sort of hardcore homophobics, but even still, like, how's this gonna work, by the way? So if we slide over a table, this is some strange shit we got going on right here. We got some strangeties, but yeah, I was just like, what the hell? But then my boss walked by as this has been said, and he found it hilarious. Not in the way of his views, but he just found hearing someone say that just absolutely absurd, which rightfully so. Not good about the RGG this time around. Yeah, and he just said, "Oh, you'd probably put the vegans in there too, would you?" And of course, he was like, of course. Why wouldn't I? This man was clearly delusional. Where the hell is my small boy? Ow. I just kind of stood there and took that. I'll be honest. I didn't really spend any time trying to dodge that. Where is he? I really wish... Do you know what? Here's a mod idea for you. Little modderinos, never named, looking at you, because... Apparently, I can ask you to do anything and you'll do it. No, I'm joking, you won't. But I like to think he does. Can you make a mod that just marks this fucking dude on the minimap? Because this is some bullshit. I mean, there is also a small chance there isn't a secret room on this floor. That is certainly possible. I know that it can happen. But I feel like it's unlikely. Unlikely enough for me to be a bit annoyed. This little lad isn't anywhere, right? I feel like I'm going crazy. I've not, somehow easily missed him. And someone's going to be like, well, there's going to be, six people in the comments, 19 minutes and 21 seconds, you see him right here. I don't know. Right. Dipping out this floor. I'm not accepting that. But yeah, it's just, I don't know. Working at a shop like that, you do just get some characters that come in. There was this old dude, and I felt so bad for him, but at the same time, I kind of didn't. So there was this old dude that used to come in, and he would come in pretty much every day. And like I said, I worked there for just over a year, and it scaled up where he was coming more and more often. By the end of me working there, it scaled up quite a lot. And he used to come in, and every time he'd come in, oh, this is gonna be a good floor for this. He would buy 2 loaves of bread. And at first we were like, this guy eats a lot of bread. And then sort of later down the line, or probably 6 months into me working there, maybe a little longer, he started to come in more than once a day to buy 2 loaves of bread. And we were kind of okay. I doubt he's eating this much bread. And then it got to the point where he was coming in 4+ times a day to buy 2 loaves of bread. And we were like, okay, this guy clearly has dementia. Like, bad. But the reason I say I felt bad with him, felt bad for him, but I also didn't, is because he was a dick. Like, I understand that people with dementia don't like accepting help because it's like they don't want to reveal that they're confused, and that's not what I meant. Like, I can understand that people are gonna be maybe aggressive or standoffish when you try to help or try to claim that they've already been in earlier today, because he was very, very adamant that he hadn't. So this is why we kind of like we just let it happen, because we couldn't stop him, we couldn't tell him otherwise. So eventually we got in contact with his son, and we said like, hey, also, oh, you gotta be kidding me. I've gotta do it again though. I can't not. So eventually we got in contact with his son. I can't remember who it was, but someone I worked with knew one of his family members. And we were like, you need to do something about this guy, because we cannot help him. And this is where the bit where I really started to not feel that bad about him being the way he was came into play. Because his son tried, like, once, and then stopped. And we kind of asked him why, and he was basically like, he was kind of a horrible old man all his life before he had dementia, and he still is now. And we were like, oh. And then on top of that, we realized during all this happening, quite a strong pattern of him being more than a little aggressive about being told he'd already been in to specifically the female employees. He would get incredibly aggressive to the point of like grabbing one of them by their shirt. Levels of like trying to grab people, and it's like I felt really bad for him, because this guy is like clearly absolutely lost it. Like he doesn't have anyone and he doesn't know where he is, but at the same time it very much seems like he was a woman-hating dickhead before he got dementia, and his son seemed to back that up as well. And it seems bad to speak ill of someone that's like not right in the mind, and I can't truly say if he was, because I didn't know him prior. But yeah, he got like real mean and aggressive, and it's like we really did try to help like multiple times when he came in, especially when it first started happening, him coming in multiple times a day. We'd be like, it's like his name was John or something along those lines. Even if it's not, I'm gonna call him John. And we're like, John, you've been in before today. Like, here's your, like, we can print off your receipt. Like, we can show you coming in on CCTV with the time and date. Like, you came in. And he was just like, nope, no, I didn't. And I, like, one of the girls was like, no, come here, I'll show you CCTV. And he like grabbed her and was like, no, I did not, leave me alone. And we're like, what are we meant to do? Like, it's such a difficult position to be put in. Because, I mean, it was also like, as well, this guy's buying all our fucking bread. Like, we're running a shop here, and there's people that, like, come in on a daily basis. Well, not one particular person, apart from him, but there was multiple people that would come in, like, to get their bread from this specific shop, and he always bought the one that everyone wanted. And we're like, sorry, we've ran out. We've had to sell nine, well, it was always in twos, we had to sell, like, eight loaves to this one guy. And, like, he wouldn't leave without them either. Like, we tried, but he never left without buying it. He'd always get it. And, like, one time he even bought it, went to leave the shop, and with it still in his hands, went round and bought another two. Like, not even realizing he literally had some in his hands. Lead cake. I like yellow chamber, though. Lead cake looks appetizing, but I also know it's just, it's not going to be spice. It looks like spice. It's not going to be spice. By the way, can I just ask, what the fuck is the sprite for spice? I've never really understood. Is it meant to be like a cube of it on a plate? Like a square plate? Is this white bit meant to be like a plate or like a napkin? And is it meant to be like a cube of spice? I don't really understand. And I've never really asked. I don't really know what it is. I'm a bit confused. I'll be honest, I'm a bit confused. I'm gonna try and buy Yellow Chamber, because Yellow Chamber's fun, and it's also a lot more health. But yeah, it's just like, it's just one of those things, isn't it, where it's like, it is really sad, but at the same time, there's a lot of other people out there with dementia that don't hate women. So it's kind of like, you sort of had us feeling bad for you, and then you started to be a bit of a dick. And the main thing I feel bad for him for as well is like, either his house or his like garbage is rubbish. It must just be so full of bread. There must just be literally hundreds of thousands of loaves of bread covering his house, every square inch. He must have just a throne of it. Can never remember what the blanc does. Is it blanc? The blanc? Gives one body to caliber to receive bullet banishing blanks. Triggered by attempting to blank with no blanks remaining. Okay. All righty then. I'll probably do this. I've not got enough for thingy, so do you know what? Tell you what. I'm gonna buy a key and open my chest. Also, here's my boy. The mailbox gun. Also, the 50-50 coin. I didn't realize that was a passive. Anybody have a chance to drop casings on damage? Nice. Let's go fight the cool boss. Let's go. But yeah, it wasn't all just sad old people. There was once a woman that came in and she, I don't know if you've heard of Zaflora before. It's like a floor cleaning solution thing that you mix with water to like mop up your floors. It smells really nice. And this woman came in once. And I just kind of, I went to restock the shelves next to her and she was just kind of sat there like, are we going to lose our synergy though? Ah, it's okay. Oh wait, no. Okay, cool. Right, I'm gonna fight my boss with the stuff I've got and then spin down afterwards. Oh, hello. Glitch secret room once again. Just gotta find the key. Eh. Where's the armor? Okay, I got the key. Now I just gotta try and find the actual chest to open it. Oh wait, I just opened one of those locked doors. Ah, heck. Bloody glitched secret room. Wasted a key. Heck in hell. Boom, 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 boom. Get bead. There's gonna be a good gun for this. Oh, I fucking love this boss. Ow! I rescind my previous comment. No, I don't. This boss is still fucking great. Very well designed. Literally my only wish is that the camera would be zoomed out a little bit. I think it'd add a lot to the fight because he'd been able to visually see what's happening on screen. Not only make it a little easier on the player, but also I think it'd add a bit more sort of ambiance to the fight because you can see like the whole room and see how much the boss is truly doing. It's a very cool boss. There you go. I love the animations as well. Animations are real good. The hell's this thing? The arc rifle. Ooh. Hell yes, we got an arc weapon. I really been wanting to show these off, so I'm glad we got it. Right, right, let's drop plague. I'm gonna keep my hive holster because that's cool. I'm gonna reroll the blanc as well. It's fine, but it's not amazing. Whoopsie, did I drop the spin down dice by accident? Oh, apparently, I think it was maybe the trash bag was giving me the double active space. I'm not sure. Drop that. Drop that. Drop that. That. And that. Boom. Right, let's hope we didn't get too many actives here. We got this, the Alpha Beam. Ooh, hello. We got this, which is the Punish Ray. Seems interesting. We got the Mailbox Gun again. Big Duck. Another active there. Ooh, absolute radiance. Wait. Okay. That's pretty awesome. I was like, absolute radiance. That's the name of the boss from what's it called? What the hell is it called? I've completely forgotten the name of it. The boss from Hollow Knight. There you go. We've also got this, which is bullet with a military hat. Persuasive bullets. These bullets are adorned with a beautiful captain's hat. The enemies of the Gungeon are all well acquainted with military hierarchy and happy to do what they're told. Interesting. We got this thing, which is the Jaws of Defeat. I'm pretty sure this is an item I haven't unlocked yet. Increase the damage and fire rate by 0.5 for every death on the current save file, up to 1,000 deaths. Unfortunately, we're not getting a massive damage bonus from that. We got 17% by the looks of it there. In fact, we can drop it and check. Yeah, 17% fire rate and damage. That's still pretty decent. We also got this. We got this, which I can't remember what this does. Cursed chamber. Yeah, cylinder even. Nearby enemies are feared when reloading. Blomp. Triggers a small blank whenever an explosion goes off. Nice. We got a glass guanstone. Hell yes. Ooh, what the hell? We got like a weird aftershadow. Some spooky stuff going on here. Right, so we got this. Maiden plating shoots 8 ledger projectiles on taking damage. The low priest cloak. Okay, don't know what that does at all. I guess we'll find out some other time. Anyways, let's be on our way. I want to use the, these two weapons, mainly. The arc rifle just seems cool to me. Want to get some use out of that for the next floor. My phone's about to go off and tell me to upload my video. Are y'all ready for this? Come on, phone. Do it. Oh, wait, no, it's not. I turned off the alarm the other day because I went to the theater. Well, I didn't go to the theater. I went to a theater to see a discussion about the TV show Inside Number 9. It was very good. Even though I've not seen the show, you may be wondering, why are you going to a discussion about a show you haven't seen? It's because of my girlfriend's birthday and she really likes the show. But it ended up being really good. Yeah, it was like the creators of the show and they were like talking about behind the scenes stuff. It was really good. Ooh. Ooh. Where are these knives coming from? I'm going to assume the knives are from the cloak. I like it though. Seems like on kill I gain a knife. This thing's super cool. I also seem to attach a... Oh, the commanding bullets are what the third party controller little thing was from. I'm also getting a curse thing above my head every so often. It's not giving me any curse, but... Oh, there you go. Look, I controlled that guy for a brief time there. And then we can use this thing with the synergy, which... it's gonna blow your mind. Oh. Y'all ready for this? This is so dumb, I love it. It doesn't do that much damage, but my god, does it absolutely blind your opponent. And me. Eviscerated. Actually, it does a good amount of damage. What the hell's this looking thing? The Blood Idol. Looks cool. Definitely made by somebody. An idol dedicated to Caliber demands the blood of the slain undead. Though you may not complete her quest in this lifetime, she is faithful and keep watch for many lifetimes. Okay, so I'm guessing we've got to fill this up over different runs. And it will do something once filled up. Pretty interesting idea. Give me more ammo, baby. I really like this thing. I have to say, one small suggestion I have for this. Oh, whoopsie. Is I'd maybe have the impact sprite be like a little faster. I don't know if you can do that. It just, I don't know, the lightning seems so quick and then the impact of the shot, like the little, you see that little spread thing here, look. It looks like it plays a little slow. It's a very, 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 very minor criticism. Otherwise, an absolutely fantastic and incredibly cool weapon. I see it then, innit? It's also nice and strong, too. Genie lamp. Right, let's drop some shit. Goodbye. Goodbye. I'm keeping this synergy. Do you know what? I'm getting rid of the double gun now. You can go. Yeah, I want to keep that. I haven't tried the punish ray yet. Do you know what? No, let's at least try the punish ray before I get rid of things, because I feel like there's a potential for this thing to be real fucking cool. It might not be, but there's a potential. So far, streak lost. Oh, it's like an accuracy buffing. The longer I can go without missing a shot, I think it gains stat bonuses. Ah, streak lost again. Y'all got fear in you. Okay, I'm not quite sure what the streak loss is referring to, but I'm gonna stop doing it now because it seems to be hurting me somewhat. I'm gonna keep all of these and then reroll all of these. Ooh, hello. I like this thing. I got two of the same gun. I need to remember that spins down to the same thing. I got the, ooh, it's got knockback. Right, let's just pick everything up and then see what happens afterwards. Right, so. Oh, this is an active? I didn't even clock onto the fact that this thing's an active. I probably should be using it a bit more often. Anyways, let's first have a look what we got through here. So, of course we know these. We don't know this. Disco Inferno. Being on fire gives stat buffs. Nice, that's cool. We've seen Old Journal. We've seen Chaos Ruby. Cool ammo. Slowly gives you ammo while in combat. That's also pretty cool. Right, weaponry-wise, we have not picked anything up yet, have we? Oh no, it's just this. This thing's pretty cool. Gun of 1,000 sins. Sidearms were carried by the accursed sorcerer who put countless innocents to death in order to secure his grab at the penultimate power. Just in time for the dragon. I don't know if this is a good bossing gun, I'm not gonna lie. I really like the ammo count for this thing. It's really cool. You see how it's like a little face and then when I shoot it, it's a dead face? That's really cool. And how the bullets themselves are like little ghosts that eat things. Yeah, I'm not sure if this is a bossing gun. I'm gonna, actually, do you know what? Let's go with this thing. Oh, it got me hit, that's fine. I love this. This is so stupid. It lags the game so hard. It's so ammo efficient as well. Oh, it's dumb and I love it. What a synergy. What a synergy it is. I'm surprised I'm not going to one cycle this guy here. Very surprised. Ow. I don't know why I didn't roll there. It was dumb. I was trying to get fancy pants. Ow. Stop being an idiot. Cool. I can't remember what curses I've cleansed in Bullet Hell, but I should try and cleanse the rest of them. I should probably try and find the shop. Let's try and get like a full suite of great items here, though. I don't really think that matters. Or that. And I don't really think... I like this, but I don't think it's going to achieve victory for us. Right. We got this thing. The Outbreak. Intriguing. The pea shooter's back again. We got the broken duplicator. We got... whatever this thing is. The hell's this thing? The risky headband. Dancing through the danger makes your aura very cool. Taking damage or dodge rolling will make takeaway from your coolness of your prior dodging. What the fuck does that mean? I am unsure. I am very unsure. I got another active. Spawns 3 junk on use. Can also summon garbage. Thank you. I just have to show this. 1 second. It fucking took me to the Prismatism mod page upon fucking using the active. It literally took me straight to it. My god. You beautiful bastard. That's so funny. Oh, that's funny. Anyways, what else we got going on here? Fuck me, that's hilarious. Thirst of Vengeance doesn't really matter to us. Grimblanks. Killing an enemy erases all of their enemy's bullets. The Glass God grants power, but shattering upon taking the bearer taking damage. And anti-magic rounds. Okay, we got some good stuff here. I'll try out this thing here. Seems good. Ooh, it also does an interesting final shot too. I like it. Very fast firing too. We're plaguing up bitches right now. And then we can also try out... I want to try out this thing on enemies. Ooh, there you go. Hey, there you go. It's like leaving little blood piles and stuff here. That's more like it. This thing's definitely more of a room clearer. I'm not sure if the blood does anything to enemies, but I'm going to assume it does something. I think it might have even just killed an enemy that walked into it there. I wasn't paying full attention, I'll be honest. Still don't really know how this thing works. Defiler. There you go. What the fuck is going on with this dude? Are you alright, sir? Are you okay? Am I meant to just have infinite blanks to kill you? You ruined my glass god thingy. How do I kill this guy again? Does anyone remember? I thought you're supposed to... Is he meant to have this many skulls around him? This feels unfair. Okay, no, he's dead. Don't worry. Don't listen to me. I mean stupid. Hey, where's my reward? Eh. Repelling rolls. Thanks. Thank you. Quite a few pool leaving weaponry here. I'm actually quite liking the weaponry we've got right now. Some good stuff. By the way, just a quick suggestion for when you do update, not a bot. I would highly suggest making spin down a lot longer charge. Like, it should take an entire floor to charge the thing. It's so it basically gives you infinite ammo at the end of the day. The red blaster. Let's try that out. Ooh, hello. Ooh, I like it. Custom beam weapons are always fun. I don't know how good it is, but it's red. Therefore, it has to be good. It seems pretty good. There's a blank. Did I take damage to that? I genuinely don't know. Okay. Y'all gotta die, fella. The knives are doing God's work right now. Die! Oh my God, how much health do you have? Cheeky motherfucker. Eh. Oh, for fuck's sake. Nah, we're leaving this floor. Hand, you've ruined it. You've ruined it, Hand. I'm not going through your rigmarole again. Get the hell out of here. I'm debating, do I even want to do bullet hell? Do you know what? Of course I do. What does this give me again? I don't know, let's just do a full run reroll, why not? Do you know what? I'm gonna keep that though. I like that. But everything else can go. Actually, that's just going to reroll into the same thing. I'll keep that synergy at least. That's a lot of full metal jackets. What the fuck? Alrighty then. Right, okay, let's just see what's going on right now. We got a good few full metal jackets. Increased ammo capacity by 50% of the current of the held gun. Okay. Clips on easy. Interesting. I want to do that to... Do you know what? I want to do that to this. I don't know what this monstrosity is. This thing looks terrible. What else did we get in there? We got some stuff. We got this cog. Increased damage for each piece of armor. That's pretty good considering how much armor we just got. We got this. Add speed and gain one ammo for every kill. Ooh, I like that. I like that. We managed to get the arc shotgun. Hell yes. I forgot that the arc weapon would just spin down into another arc weapon. Look at that, bad boy. Hell yes. Okay, this the shotgun doesn't seem to have the same issue with the slow on-hit effect. Maybe I'm just stupid. It feels like it's different. Feels like it's different. I don't know. I do not know. Indeed, I do not know. Oh my lord. Right. I'm excited for our new build. I do like the spin down dice's ability to just give you weapons you shouldn't have from mods, which is just hilarious to me. You know what? Just give me them all. Oh no, it's still the same. It's only a tiny bit slow. Not like mage. Oh my god. This is so heckin' fucked. This thing pops off though. If you could come back into my reach, fella, that'd be nice. Ow. Have the feeling I'm going to create some issues for myself with all these points of not being able to shoot. Also, want to try out this thing. I kind of want to save this for the boss, though. Thing looks pretty hilarious. We kind of need to make sure enemies die in the center of the room, otherwise we are so screwed. God, this thing's so good. Give me ammo for this bad boy. This thing's awesome. I'm really enjoying using it. Oh wait, so not every curse takes effect every room. We've just been getting unlucky. Oh my god. This is so good. Get him, thank you. Ah, he hit me. Wasted my blank. I can't believe he did this. Calm down, you big boy. Come on. Go away. There you go. Ow. My god. This gun. It's so satisfying to use. I wish this was in base Gungeon. Console players need this in their life. This is so enjoyable. This thing is deeply satisfying. Just, I love the animation for it. It just feels like it has oomph. It feels like firing a lightning gun. I know that sounds stupid, but it does. What's this? Got the ammo gun, which is always fun. And the cursed tumbler or something it was called. Isn't tumbler already cursed? Where the hell's it gone? There it is. Gives chests a chance to be jammed. Ah, okay. Cool. Oh, hello, sir. I am a tank. Oh, no. No, I'm not. I am a tank. Hear me roar. Where have you gone? You big bad bitch. Oh, for God's sake, I was trying to be a tank. You're not even gonna let me be a tank? Where are you, you big whiff? Come back. Stop spawning your shitty little minions. There you go. I want to be a tank. This is fucking nuts. I'm gonna guess this boss gets harder the more curses you have enabled. Because this boss is significantly harder than it's ever been in the past. I can smell your fear. Oh shit, he's not dead. Fucking love this fight. There's some cool-ass custom bosses in modding now. Curse thee. You think you can curse thee? Look, it sounds so weedy. Let's listen to the bazooka. Ooh, this thing's pretty good. I love this thing, it's so dumb. Definitely not an intended item. In fact, the description proves it's not intended by, for one, not existing within my inventory. It's literally not there. Okay. This is kind of fucked. There's gonna be like 1 inch of this room in which we can fire, and it is right here. Thank God. I am thoroughly enjoying this. This is what bullet hell should be like. Not quite as chaotic as this. I made it a little more chaotic than it had to be, but I'm thoroughly enjoying how difficult bullet hell is, with the little mini bosses, the extra additional challenges. It's just all stuff bullet hell needed. If you actually want additional challenge, like, because is it like in base dungeon, the whole point of bullet hell is it's meant to be an additional challenge on top of a normal run. But once you've played it more than like 7 or 8 times. Well, won it more than 7 or 8 times. It's really no longer a challenge. It's just kind of there. It just kind of exists. Y'all wanna slow your roll, boys. These heckin' boys are fast. I wonder, I do want to know if I can spin this down again once more into another arc rifle. I think I can, but I'm not sure. I think it might go arc pistol, arc rifle, arc shotgun, but it might also go arc rifle, arc shotgun, arc something else. And I don't want to lose this thing if I don't have to, but I also do want to find out what's next. Like, I don't know all the arc weapons. There might be an arc minigun that I'm missing. Who knows? I couldn't deprive you of that if it exists. God damn, these things are so heckin' fast. Stop being so fast. Let's get up in there. Good. Another one cleansed. You cheeky motherfucker. Heroin? I don't care. Could spin it down. Not even bothered. God damn, this is so crazy. I think the play around this is difficult, but I like it. Oh my god, how did I not get hit then? This weapon's just, like, the best weapon for bullet hell. It's so enjoyable. I keep saying it, but I've got a pat never named on the back with this one. It's cool as shit, and it's super fun. It looks, the visuals are just superb. I don't know, this one's pretty top tier for me. This would make my top 5 list of modded weapons. This thing's pretty heckin' cool. Did that guy just try and suck up my laser? I've gotta try and throw them back at me, I dare you. How could you? Okay, he can't throw them, and he can throw them back, but the game does not like it. Although that's a bug that can't really be foreseen or prevented, I don't think. Do you want to chill out, big purple boy? Boom. Look at that. Beautiful. And chests out the wazoo. The infinity as well. Hell yeah. Not like I'm going to use any of them, but I've got a full clear because I might have some more cleansing shrines about. It's going to be kind of a long run, but hey ho. This is such a fun challenge. Doing bullet hell with all the modifiers on, it's an absolute blast. I mean, I will admit, I'm on a rather strong run here, because if you get a spin down dice, your run's just one. But still, like, this is such an enjoyable experience. Somebody did a great job of making bullet hell just a hell of a lot more interesting and worth going to. It's not just an assured victory now if you actually want to play with the modifiers on. The hell's this thing? The Sydney Sleeper. And lots of different sniper rifles here. Oh, that hit me. It's okay. We're good. We're good. What? Oh my god. I'm taking some dumb damage right now. Dumb damage. Do, 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 do. Look at that. Look at that chain shot. All three of them in one shot is beautiful. Right, few more rooms. I've actually got some health to get there. Calm down. Beautiful. Seems like we're only going to get to cleanse two curses this time around. Only two curses to cleanse. Shoot. Rifle, shoot. I didn't realize it was one of those patterns on me. Okay, I got hurt by the poison there. Not really much I could have done to avoid that one. Anyways, we'll be on our way. See that? Just sidestep that bitch. Okay, these make non-shooty rings too. Let's be careful. Let's try and use our tank gun a little bit here. Wait, it says the name. Item string not found. Hell yes. Love that name. That guy dropped a key. What the hell? Ow. Unnecessary damage there. Yes, I got it. The arc pistol. I did unfortunately bug out the on-screen display. But I got it, the arc pistol. This is probably the last version. Probably not as good as the shotgun, but still. I wanted to show them all off. Might even end up dying here. I've not really fought this this far into this boss in a while. I remember it mostly. Okay, this probably isn't the best gun for this. Try it, this bad boy. Okay, I just want to quickly check. This is the last one of this, isn't it? Oh, what the? The Liberty Flib. Okay, I'm pretty sure I remember what this thing is, and it will hurt your ears a little, so just be prepared when I fire this thing. But I am going to fire it, because it's very cool. Both visually and just everythingly. There you go. That's a lot of noise. But it is tremendously beautiful. Tremendously beautiful. God damn it, I just love the magazine animation on this thing. The little magazine sprite, should I say, not animation. You all knew what I meant. Right. We're wrecking them. And we have killed him. That was a very fun run. Spin down dice once again makes this just a very pleasurable experience. And it's a long ass episode too, which I'm sure people aren't going to be mad at. We danged full cleared. Either way, I hope you guys did enjoy this one. Very fun episode indeed. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.